Hello friends, I am Naval Yemul, working as an assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to see the programs on C++. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to understand basic programs of C++. Content of this video is the programs on C++. So we'll see the first program, plus program, to find the square root of a number. So here we are using two header files. One is IOStream and one is Math. IOStream is used for input output functions like Cout and Cin, and Math is used as a scientific calculator. In this program, we are finding the square root of any number. So for that, the function required is sqrt. It is a function to find the square root of any number. So the main program starts with the third line, that is int main, then followed by the int number and float result. Here two data types are used, that is integer and float, and two variables are used, that is number and result. Cout is used, then insertion operator, enter a number. Enter a number is displayed on the screen. Then the user enters a number that is stored in number, that is NO. Cin, extraction operator, and the number entered by the user is stored in a number. Then there is a logic, or here the result is calculated as the function is sqrt, then followed by the number. So here the whatever the answer that is stored in the result should be displayed on the screen. That displayed is given with the function, that is cout. Square root of a number is, then insertion operator, result. Then we are using insertion operator and end L. End L is a manipulator that is used to get the cursor for the next line. So the program output will be enter a number. Suppose user enters 16 as a number, the square root of a number will be 4.0, because the result is in float. So we'll see the next program, that is C++ program to find the square of any number. The logic for this program is very simple, that is n square. So we are using a header file and a math file, two header files. Then main program starts here, then int two variables, n comma result. Cout, enter a number. Whatever the number entered by the user is stored in n. And here the logic here is result is equal to, the function used is POW, that is power, in bracket n comma 2, where the first digit, that is n, shows a base and followed by the order or raised to. So here n comma 2 refers to n raised to 2. N is a number which is taken from the user and raised to 2, so we get a square of any given number. Then the C out will be square of the given number is equal to, then followed by the result. So whatever we are used the logic, that is power n comma 2, that is stored in the result, and the result is displayed here. So the output will be like this. Enter a number. Suppose user enters 4 as a number, the square of the given number is 16. So the logic here in this program is POW function power n comma 2. So the next program, it is very simple here. C++ program to find the cube of any number. If you understand the previous program, this program becomes very simple. Here everything is same here. Just we are using function power n comma 3, that is n raised to 3. Again here n is a base and 3 is the order or raised to. So I'll read this program once again. Int two variables, n comma result. N is a variable which is taken from the user, and result is used to calculate the result, that is power or cube of this program. So cout, enter a number that is stored in n. Result is calculated as the function POW power n, 3. The cube of the given number will be, the result is called here, and NL manipulator is used so that the cursor moves to the next line. So the output will be like this. Enter a number 3. The cube of a given number is 27. That is 3 raised to 3. It gives 27. So pause this video for a few seconds and think on writing a program to find the power of any number. Okay, we'll see this program. So C++ program to find power of any number. So again, we are using two header files. Then we are using three variables here, that is base, comma power, comma results. So base and power are two variables, and result variable is used to calculate base raised to power. So see out, enter base and power. The two numbers which taken from the user are stored in base and power. Result will be power, base, comma power. So what the first number will be on base, and the second number entered by the user will be of power. The see out will be power of a given number is equal to, and result is called here, and NL manipulator is used again. So for example, if enter base and power, if the user enters 3, 4, the power of a given number will be 3 raised to 4, that gives 81 as a result. So we'll see next program, that is C++ program to enter the equilateral side of the equilateral triangle and finding the area of that. So the logic here is area is equal to root 3 by 4 into a square gives the area of the equilateral triangle. So we need to know the logic of the program, that is area of the equilateral triangle. Here again we are using two header files, one is IOStream and math, and we are taking two variables, that is int a for the side of the equilateral triangle and float area to calculate the area of the equilateral triangle. So see out, enter the side of the equilateral triangle, and that whatever the side is entered, that's stored in a. Then area is calculated as square root. The function here is sqrt, square root of 3 divided by 4.0 into a. Here 4.0 is used because area is a variable from float data type, so we are using 4.0 here. Then see out, area of the equilateral triangle is, then area is called. The output will be like this. Enter the side of the equilateral triangle, that is equal to 10. The area of the equilateral triangle will be 43.30. So we'll see the next program, that is to find the simple interest. The logic here is simple, of the simple interest is P into N into R divided by 100. P is principal, N principal amount, N is rate of period, and R is the rate of interest. So here we are using only one header file, iostream.h, then int three variables in integer and one variable in float, that is SI. So we need to take a three variables for principal amount as P and period of time as N and the rate of interest as R. All three variables taken from the user are stored in P, N and R. Here the logic is SI, that is simple interest, is equal to P into N into R divided by 100.0. 100.0 is used because SI is a variable taken from the float data type. So your simple interest is given as SI. So SI is a variable where the result is stored and SI is called here. The output will be enter the principal amount, the period of time and the rate of interest. If the user enters 1 lakh and period of time as 2 and rate of interest as 12, your simple interest will be 24,000. C++ program to find the compound interest. The logic here is compound interest P into 1 plus R by 100 raised to N. So we are using two adder files here because we want to use power as a function. So the logic here is CI is equal to P into power of 1 plus R by 100 comma N, where 1 plus R by 100 is a base raised to N, that is comma N, that all is calculated by a function POW, and those all value is multiplied with the principal into P. So here again there are three variables taken in integer, and CI variable is taken in float. So C out, enter principal amount, period of time and rate of interest. C in will be stored in P, N and R, and the logic as explained before, C out your compound interest will be, and CI is called. So the output will be enter principal amount, period of time, rate of interest 100, 2 and 12. Your compound interest will be 125.44. So we'll see a program to find the area of circle. As we all know, the logic here for area of circle is pi r square. So we are using math as a header file again. Here the function POW is used again for r comma 2, where r is the radius which is entered by the user and stored in r comma 2, that is raised to r, and those all values multiplied with pi value, that is 3.14. So that all value is stored in A. So we have taken A in float as a data type. So area of circle and A is called here. So enter the radius of circle 5. Area of circle will be 78. So references. Thank you.